behalf of the family, I just want to say thank you to everyone who came to celebrate the life of Johnnie. Your presence is so meaningful, and it's comforting, and it brings a peace to this family. And so today, we're not just going to be talking about passing. We're going to talk about life, and we're going to celebrate together. So let's open up with a word of prayer. Lord, thank you for today. Thank you that we get to celebrate a life well lived today, a life that is so meaningful to each person in this room. Someone who each person shares such sweet memories with. And God, I pray that your presence would be here, that your Holy Spirit would bring a comfort and a peace that surpasses our understanding, that you would flood hearts and minds with more memories that would just bring joy to each person. That as we've gathered together as family and friends, that would be what holds us strong, that you are our foundation, but a comfort that is so amazing when we get to be with one another. So Lord, we love you. We pray that you're glorified this morning. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a song, How Great Thou Art.
Great.
Johnnie Mae Aaron of Farmers Branch, Texas, passed away peacefully on July 12, 2022 at the Willow Creek Senior Living in Allen. Johnnie was born September 25, 1932 in Westminster, Texas, to Ollie Wesley Parks and Ruby Pate Hughes. She married Homer Aaron December 24, 1953 in McKinney, Texas. Johnnie was preceded in death by her husband, Homer Lee Aaron, son, Norman Lee Aaron, parents, Ruby and Ollie Parks, sister, Alice Charlene Bunky Parks Dewar, brothers, Horace Buck Parks, Jackie Parks, Charles Sugg Parks. Johnnie is survived by sisters, Patsy Iona Miller, Relda Lenora Miller, Mary Faye Scooter Newsy, daughters Brenda Aaron Carter, Linda Aaron Tarkington, grandchildren Nicole Adams, Jonathan Carter, Joshua Carter, Brianna Tarkington, great-grandchildren Colby, Laney, Jackson, and numerous nieces and nephews. Johnnie, or Nanny, as the kids called her, was a loving wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother. She loved bird watching and enjoyed seeing the natural beauty the world has to offer. Growing up in a big family, Johnnie loved taking care of others. If you ever went to her house on an empty stomach, she would take care of you with the good old Southern hospitality she was known for. She was a great listener and would enjoy doing puzzles while talking with loved ones. Johnnie made a positive impact on everyone she came in contact with and will be missed dearly by everyone. Now I want to read the 23rd Psalm. It's just such an awesome passage of hope and comfort from the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pasture. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
When I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky, the first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane. Or I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will share the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down. Step for step, and I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will share the sins and struggles I have carried all these years. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, good to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace.
Once again, I just want to say thank you all for being here. Your presence is a tribute to a life well lived. And I do want to say also thank you for your comfort, your concerns, your kind words, your prayers. All of these things are so meaningful during a time like this. The loss of a loved one is one of the most difficult times that any one of us would face in life. Grief is never comfortable for any of us. It's never something that we desire in life, but it's something that we all experience. It's difficult to know what to say at times like this. How do you do justice in describing almost 90 years of life in a short moment worth of time? 90 years of life well lived. And I believe that the answer is not so much in celebrating a death, because that's not what we're here to do. We are here to celebrate a life. A life of respect, love, commitment, and hard work. I didn't have the honor, the pleasure of knowing Johnnie, but just talking with some of you guys and hearing memories and hearing about this life, it's an honor for me to stand up here and talk and experience this time with you guys. Proverbs 11:16 says this: "A gracious woman attains honor." I'm going to say it again, a gracious woman attains honor. Today we've gathered together to honor the memory of a gracious woman. And I want to talk about a couple of things that I've learned about her in the short time. The first thing is that her goals were high. She would have worked circles around, I believe, most people in this room. I know she would have worked circles around me growing up, working in cotton fields while still getting her education and graduating, and then becoming a stay-at-home mom and raising her kids and wanting to provide the best life that she could for those who were in her care. What a role model for every single person in here. What a way for each one of us to be able to follow suit. Her joys were simple. Her friendship was unquestionable. Being a close-knit family, she enjoyed cooking for those she loved, caring for grandkids, great-grandkids, hanging out with friends and family. She made her focus on those around her. She was a stable woman in an unstable world. And can we talk about commitment for just a second? She was a devoted wife to Homer Aaron for almost 60 years. That date in the obituary to me, December 24th, 1953, I was told Homer passed around 9 years ago. I believe in 2012 is what I heard. And so right around 60 years of marriage, what an unbelievable accomplishment. What an amazing feat, an amazing thing that each one of us can strive for. Let's talk about discipline for a second. I didn't just hear, I see the paddle over there on the table, and I heard that wasn't exactly the only paddle that she had, maybe a wooden spoon or whatever else. I guess her motto could have been the passage, "Spare the rod, spoil the child." And I was told by some that she didn't use it, and I was told by others that she did use it. And so if you think about that for a second, maybe it was the person who it was used on was kind of the case. The list of memories goes on and on for each one of you. Each one of you have your special time, your special moments that you shared with Johnnie. And I believe that that's something that the Lord gives us, and it's special and unique to each individual. It's special and unique to each one of you. So although that Johnnie is not physically here with us anymore, you will never forget the impact that she made in your life. Her life will continue to speak meaningful things to the lives that she was a part of as long as each one of you live. So a couple things that I would like to close with. The first is this: the presence of friends and family is comforting. In times of loneliness and sorrow, the presence of friends and loved ones is so meaningful. Certain strength comes by close personal relationships, close personal presence of those who are dear to us. Second, find comfort and peace in the Lord. Whatever friends and loved ones may bring, God is our supreme source of comfort. To those who are cast down, He comes to lift up our sad spirits. He calls upon us to find refuge in Him. Psalm 31 verse 1 says, "In you, O Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed." And again in Matthew chapter 11, 28 through 30, Jesus says, "Come to me, all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." And lastly, be reminded that death isn't the end of life. Romans chapter 14, 7 and 8 says, "For not one of us lives for himself, and not one dies for himself. For if we live for the Lord, or if we die for the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's." In John chapter 11, Jesus has a conversation with his good friend Martha when he says, "I'm the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even if he dies. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I have believed that you are the Christ, the Son of God, even he who comes into the world." Friends and family, Johnnie loved the Lord. She made the most important decision that any one of us can make, and that's to give her life to Christ. Johnnie has been delivered through our Lord Jesus Christ and is in his presence at this very moment because she responded to Jesus with, "Yes, Lord, I believe." Take comfort in knowing that today. So once again, Proverbs 11:16 says, "A gracious woman attains honor." Johnnie was a gracious woman, and looking around this room with people who knew her and loved her, one thing becomes very clear to me. If life is measured by what's left behind, her life was truly a successful one. She will be greatly missed by all who knew her. Will y'all pray with me? Lord, thank you for this time that we've shared together and that we continue to share together as we honor this life. Johnnie impacted each person in this room with special moments, with special memories. I pray that her legacy would carry on in each person that's here. That maybe over the next few weeks and months, God, that you would just put a sweet memory in their minds of something that they experienced with her. That it might be something that would bring tears to our eyes, but it would be an overall joy that they got to experience life with her. Lord, we love you. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. This next song that we're going to listen to was very neat to me. Whenever I came in today, the family said, "Hey, we're going to have a Christmas song this play, Oh Come All You Faithful." And the reason why is because they found a picture, and on the back of the picture, Johnnie wrote back there that she wanted this song played at her funeral. And so this family is honoring her request with that.
Bethlehem.
And they hear your
Says that you draw near to the brokenhearted, and God, I pray that you would be near today. That your Holy Spirit has been in our presence today, and just continue to comfort this family. God, I pray that you would also remind us that Johnnie is no longer hurting, that Johnnie is no longer sick, that she is healed because she is in your presence. But your word says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And God, the moment that she left this place, she opened her eyes in glory. And God, we thank you for the hope that's found in Christ, and it's in his name that we pray. Amen.
morning, and we now commit her body to the ground with full assurance that one day this body will come out of this ground. Johnnie is with the Lord already, but on Resurrection Day she will receive a glorified body, and her salvation will be complete, spirit, soul, and body. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, 13 through 18, Paul writes, "But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words." Let's pray. Lord, thank you for Johnnie's life. Thank you for the celebration of life that we had this morning. Thank you for the hope that's found in Christ, that her body is, that you're not done with her body here. That one day you're going to come back and raise this body back to life. God, that in you we can all be reunited together, that we can see her again. Lord, thank you for the hope that is only found in Christ. I pray that as we leave this place and continue our lives, Lord, that you would be with each one of us. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.